Good morning, children. How are you all? Today I am going to teach you the first chapter of your English reader, that is The Tiny Teacher. Here in this chapter you will come to know about the tiniest creature, that is ant. Okay, if I'll ask you that name any tiny creature, maybe some of you may give me the reply like mosquito, some of you may say that fly. But children, the ant is the tiniest creature. And in this chapter, you will come to know a lot about this tiny creature. Means how they are working, okay, how they are living, and how we human being can learn a lot with this tiny creature. So this observation has come from the people, those who have kept this tiny creature as the pet. And they have observed their activities, and based on their observations, we have come to know a lot about this tiny creature. The ant used to talk, and ants have feelers, okay, feelers there, antenna you can say. And with the help of their feelers, they used to talk with each other. They used to touch their feelers, and this way they used to talk with each other. Generally, we used to see two kinds of ants, red and black. But there are many more, and they used to live under the soil. There they made their nest, and their nest is known as anthill. In their anthills, many rooms are there, okay, and these rooms are occupied by the different ants. Means according to their work, these rooms are also divided to them. Like some of the ants have the duty to clean the anthills, some of them have the duties to take care of the young grubs, some of them have the duty to guard the anthill. So some of them are called soldiers, some of them are called workers, some of them are called cleaners likewise. And there is one queen ant, and this queen ant is the mother of that entire population of that anthill. In the beginning, the mother ant has two wings, okay, but the queen ant cast off its wings when she took a fight, and that fight is known as wedding fight, okay. And when this queen ant fight with a male ant, that fight is known as wedding fight. And after that, it cast off its wings. And after that fight, this queen ant does nothing, only lays eggs. And this eggs first turn into grubs, then it becomes cocoon, and then after it becomes a baby ant. And this baby ant are take care by the workers ant. They totally take care of this baby ant, and until they become grown up, till then they just take care of them. And after that, these ants also divided in different sections according to the work. Some of them deployed to the duty of cleaning, some of them are deployed to the work of taking care of the young ones, some of them have the duty to guard the nest, means soldiers likewise. The worker ants has the duty to find out the food, and there is also one storeroom in their anthill where they used to store their foods. The soldier ants have to do nothing, they have to only guard the ants and the anthills. So they are not going out to find out any food. In the anthills, not only ants live, but they also give permission to live some other creatures. And why they used to give some other creatures to live there? Like some of them used to live there because the ants like their smell. Okay, they like their smell, that is very pleasant. And for that purpose, they used to live there. Some of the creatures, they used to keep there as their pet. As we human beings keeps them, keeps the dog and cat as our pet, this ant also keep some of the creatures as their pet. Some of the creatures they used to keep because they like the juice provided by them. Okay, so in this way you will see that none of the ant, either the worker or the cleaners or the nurses, never fight with each other. All the time they do their work separately. So at last I would like to say, you children, that they are really very tiny creature, but in the real sense they are a big teacher. We human beings have progressed a lot. We have made a lot of progress in every field. But even though we can learn so many things with these are tiny teachers, like how to live a disciplined life, how to be our own self, how to do our duty honestly, okay, and with sincerity. So they are not only tiny creatures, they are a big teacher also for us. Okay, so we can learn so many things with this tiny teacher. Thank you.